Hi, welcome to Coding Droplets and thank you for watching this video. In this video, I'll walk you through a very hot topic, and that is WebAssembly, which is also called as WASM, W-A-S-M. I hope you are excited to learn about WebAssembly. So this video is a WebAssembly for beginners tutorial. Now let's continue with our WebAssembly tutorial or WASM tutorial. And first, let's see what is WebAssembly. To be precise, WebAssembly is an open standard for running binary programs in browsers with native performance. So for explaining about WebAssembly, I will show you some examples. Let's take an example of Android or iOS apps, or even we can take an example of desktop applications like Windows applications or Linux applications. So for using those applications, we must install it first. Then the whole application will run locally on the device. We can use APIs for fetching or writing data to a database which is in a server. But apart from the API requests, rest all things work locally on the device. Now let us take an example of a web application. We used to host the web application in a web server. A web application is having two different processes, client side and server side, which is sometimes referred as front end and back end. Normally HTML, CSS files and JavaScript files will get downloaded to the client side, and the application will send HTTP requests to the server for processing the server-side code. Just assume that we have a login page in our web application. The user will enter the username and password to authenticate. In this scenario, the username and password will get sent to the server using an HTTP request, and it will get validated from the server. If the validation is successful, the server will redirect the user to the main page or a different page. So while loading the main page, again, this HTML, CSS files and JavaScript files for that page will also get downloaded to the client from the server. Now, WebAssembly works in a different way. We can say that it is the combination of normal web application and the desktop or Android iOS applications, which we have discussed before. When we access the application, means when we access the WebAssembly application URL in a browser, it will download the application along with the binaries. That means not only the HTML, CSS or JavaScripts, but also the binary files needed to run the application. Then the application will start running in the browser locally. That means the biggest advantage is we don't need to install the application. We can directly start running, or we can directly start using the application locally by just browsing the application URL. As it is running locally, the performance of the application will be much better. So WebAssembly provides a way to run code written in multiple languages on the web at near native speed. And please don't forget to give me a thumbs up for this video if you liked it. Also, let me know your feedback in comment section. WebAssembly is designed to complement and run alongside JavaScript using the WebAssembly JavaScript APIs. You can load WebAssembly modules into a JavaScript app and share functionality between the two. This allows you to take advantage of WebAssembly's performance and power and JavaScript's expressiveness and flexibility in the same app, even if you don't know how to write WebAssembly code. Now let's have a look on the pros and cons of WebAssembly. So the pros are, the first point is, once the application is loaded to the client device, the UI reacts much faster to the user interactions as the entire content of the application has been downloaded on the client device or on the client side. Now the second point, since the application is downloaded on the client side, the application can work offline except for the API requests to the server. So as I told before, now here the application is completely working on client side. So if we need to fetch data or write data to a database which is in the server, we have to use APIs. So the application is downloaded to the client side and the application can work offline, but for the API requests, the application has to be online or there should be a network connectivity. Then only the API request will reach the server and respond back. Now going to the cons of WebAssembly, there is only one point. The initial loading may take some time. So as the application binaries must be downloaded to the client side, it may take some time for the initial loading. It purely depends upon the size of the application binaries. But once it is downloaded, it will be cached, and second time onwards, the application can load faster. So here you can see an article in Mozilla Developer Center. So here, if we are scrolling down, I'll do one thing. I will mention this URL in the video description. So you can scroll down and here you can see the browser's compatibility. So in which versions of the browsers WebAssembly is supported. So you can find the details here. So you can see here Chrome, Edge, Firefox, Internet Explorer. In Internet Explorer, WebAssembly is not supported. Opera, Safari. So all these are desktop browsers. And in mobile browsers, we have WebView, Android, Chrome, Firefox, Opera, Safari, Samsung Internet, all those browsers. So in all these browsers, WebAssembly is supported. You can find the details here. And I need to show you one more thing. So for developing WebAssembly, now currently these many languages are supported: C, C++, C Sharp, Rust. So we can develop WebAssembly applications using these languages. In .NET Blazor, we can develop WebAssembly applications. We have already done .NET Blazor tutorial series, and you can find the playlist link mentioned in the description. Blazor provides two different types of development options. One is server app, and the second one is WebAssembly app. So by choosing WebAssembly app, we can start developing WebAssembly applications in Blazor. The development processes are same for server apps and WebAssembly apps, but in WebAssembly apps, we normally use APIs for any kind of database interactions. As I told before, because the database is in the server and the application is completely running on the client side. So that's it for this video. Hope you are clear with the points. If you have any doubts, just ask me in the comments section. So please like the video, share the video, and subscribe the channel. See you all in the next video. Thank you.